Hello once again, welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to teach you a different topic. Today we are going to learn how to express necessity, and I'm going to teach you two common expressions that are used in English. The first is have to, and the second is need to. We can use have to or need to very similarly. We can use them to express an obligation or a necessity. We can also use them in present, in past, in future, and with other tenses. And we can use them in affirmative, negative, or interrogative ideas. So, we need to separate the subjects I, you, we, and they, because I'm going to teach them in simple present, and the subjects he, she, it, also in the simple present, right? So the first idea that I have here, I have to work on Mondays. It's an affirmative idea. It corresponds to one of the subjects. And the first element is I, which is my subject. Then I use have to or need to, that are my expressions for necessity. And these expressions are in simple present. And after that, I use the verb in simple form. I need to work, I have to work. It is the same idea, so I just have two options. If I feel comfortable with have to, that is okay. If I feel comfortable with need to, that is okay. It's up to you, it's your decision, right? Then, for the negative form, remember we are talking about the present and these subjects. We use the auxiliary don't. This auxiliary corresponds to this in the simple present. And then we use the expression, we don't have to wear a uniform. At the university I work in, we don't have to wear a uniform. We can do it, but it is not necessary, okay? Or we don't need to wear a uniform. Once again, it's not a necessity. It's the same idea, I just have two options. We don't. Then, after my expression, you use the verb in simple form. Finally, as a question, do they have to study English? Like your children or your friends, do they have to study English? Do they need to study English? It is the same idea. It depends on you, on what you want to use. And for the subjects I, you, we, and they in the simple present, we use the auxiliary do, then the subject, your expression in simple form. It is in simple form because you have the auxiliary and then your verb in simple form. It is very important you remember that after your expressions need to or have to, you never conjugate the verb. Okay? For example, I have to work. No, that is not correct. Or we don't have to, I don't know, we don't have to study it in past. That is not correct. Your verb is always in simple form, right? So these are the rules for need to or have to in the simple present. Our subjects are I, you, we, and they. It changes a little bit if we are talking about the subjects he, she, it, because these are like sometimes difficult for Mexican or Spanish learners. You have to use a different rule. My first idea is affirmative. He has to work every day, or he needs to work every day. Have to and need to express exactly the same. But remember that you have to make a little change here. It's not correct if you say he have, or he need, because it's in present, your S is necessary. He needs to, he has to. And after your expression, which is in present, you use the verb in simple form. He has to work every day, not he has to work. That is not correct. My second idea is a negative form. Remember, we are using present, And the auxiliary for present, he, she, it is doesn't. Now, when we use the auxiliary, as you can see, the expression changes. It is not correct if you say she doesn't has to or she doesn't needs to. The S after your expression is not necessary because you are using the auxiliary. So she doesn't have or she doesn't need. That is the correct. And finally, your verb in simple form. Or if you want to ask a question, you use the auxiliary that corresponds for the present subjects he, she, it, which is does. Then you use your subject, dog. Dog is a third person, it's an it, right? And then your expression goes in simple form. Once again, in negative and interrogative, you have an auxiliary. So you don't conjugate your expression. For example, if you say, does your dog has to or does your dog needs to? That is not correct. You don't have to use the S because your S is here. And after, you use the verb in simple form, right? So as you can see, we can use have to or need to in simple present. We can also use them in past. You just have to remember the rules for the past. Instead of does or do, you use did. And instead of doesn't, you use didn't. And your expressions are in simple form when you have the auxiliary, or your expression goes in past when you don't use the auxiliary. The past of have to is had to, and the past of need to is needed to. So I just hope you can remember these rules, and I hope you have learned how to express necessity in English. This is just one of the expressions we can use. I'm going to teach you other expressions, but that will be in another video. I hope you have enjoyed the video, and thank you very much. If you have any comments, if you have any questions, please feel free to leave them below, and I will be attending you. Thank you very much, and have a very nice day. Bye-bye.